Yeah, when you come back, we're good to go.
Oh my
Okay.
God. Guys, sorry. I was seriously, I
We are
was
good to
about a
go.
minute away from giving up. I could not get, there was just something I have no fucking clue with OBS that wanted to be
Yeah,
a complete piece of shit, but
we're good to go.
let's go.
What's
So,
up? Yes, so
hey.
yeah, here we go. We're
Shit. How did we not do that?
Someone joined my room. What the fuck is going on here? Someone just joined the room and grabbed it.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck. Whatever. Hello,
Okay.
sir.
Well, whatever. All right. So,
Although, yeah, we have to make sure they're muted. Like, no
yeah,
offense.
I don't know how to do that on your side. It's your room.
Oh, you know what? So, no, we're gonna. Sorry, we're
This
kicking you out.
is
Sorry, this is private room. We're doing a live stream. Sorry, we can't do that. All right, so what are we doing here, Aiden Paladin, on your channel?
Yeah, we're going to be watching the state. Yeah, the problem is it has the URL. I don't know how to get rid of that.
The
Since I'm streaming
URL
from
of Rabbit?
of your
Oh, I don't
channel,
care.
but it's
That's always
just,
on mine.
yeah, just leave the
That's
room.
totally fine,
Just
yeah.
make the room private, I guess.
Yeah, I'll just kick your ass out. That's fine.
So the State is a four-part television series slash movie that's made by BBC4, and Hardbastard talked about it, and I was like, wow, we should watch that because that sounds like absolute straight up propaganda.
This is literally ISIS propaganda being shown on the airwaves of Channel 4 in wherever that broadcasts in the UK. That,
Yeah.
to me, I think, if the organization or country that you're at war with is broadcasting their propaganda over your networks, that's you might be a defeated country.
Just a little bit.
Maybe.
One of the reasons that we are streaming this, though, too, is because I'm pretty sure, my Doctor Who video, at least, the BBC is relentless about not allowing naughty people to watch their stuff and talk about it. So we're gonna be
Yes.
streaming it. It'll probably go up, but I'm not gonna. It's highly likely, unlikely to be monetized. So anyway, with that,
Yeah,
let's
let's
get into
begin.
this absolute nightmare. And
Yep.
everybody in the chat, if you can hear both of us, also tell me if you can. The volume is okay on this, and I'll see what I can do. There's not much I can. It's on max.
Oh my God. This is gonna be ridiculous.
I
I haven't seen a second of
know.
this
Neither
so
have I,
far.
so we're completely going in blind.
Hey, little man.
I want to kill myself because I know what this is gonna, what they're gonna do here.
It hasn't even started yet. You already want to kill
Oh my
yourself.
God, how are they doing this? Okay.
My God. Yeah, I know. I mean, I feel the same way because we know exactly how bad this is gonna be.
Yeah. Now, I thought this was supposed to be a documentary. It seems like it's like a television show.
It is. It's not a documentary outright. It's supposed to just be like a fictionalization
Oh, they're not in actual Syria.
No, it's a TV show. No, that's even
Oh.
worse that when they
Yeah, because
can.
I was wondering why they were like making exceptions and being nice and not immediately cutting white boy's head off because it's not real. Okay.
How do you think this
Okay.
could possibly
Now I
exist?
understand why they didn't immediately behead or kidnap the infidel. Okay.
Right.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, docudrama, somebody said, is the term for it. But yeah, ISIS propaganda is probably a more
Oh,
apt way of
absolutely.
describing it. Yeah, you gotta leave your old life behind. Factory reset. That's not subtle at all.
Or you're getting rid of the jihadi plans before you get
Or
on the
that.
airplane.
Or that. What are you talking about? You know they're all peaceful.
I know they would never do that. Yes, I am gonna blow this plane the fuck up.
Jesus Christ. You are so intolerant. It makes me sick.
I am intolerant of terrorism and terrorist
That's
propaganda.
True.
Fuck it.
Uh-oh. Get out of here. Yeah, that would have been great if the plane door closed and it's just the sound clip of Allahu Akbar and then the... Yeah, everyone notices I have a fake copy of Windows, and I torrented this, obviously.
Of course. I'm not paying for ISIS propaganda.
Yeah, it's like I'm not paying for Windows.
Supporting terrorism. Fuck that.
Pretty much. Yeah, no, thank you. Yeah, people pointed that out, and I know in that article they talked about it too, how the women don't wear hijabs and no one really has an issue with it.
I really thought it was like, I was like, wow, ISIS is trying to get some PR. I didn't realize that they have people in the UK doing it for them.
No, when they make their documentaries, it's a little bit different. They just take a little kid and have him shoot somebody.
You're not wearing a hijab. You're catching a beating before you get on the van.
Oh, yeah. He's not answering. It was all arranged, but I just...
What is it? Time to go.
Lulu, warning!
Stand no!
Wait!
We can't cross yet, we have to wait here.
What is it? What's going on?
And they've all got their nice bags packed, like they're going on vacation.
I know. Bringing your fucking son? What are
you
doing?
Yeah, what the fuck? Will they do that?
I know. Sick.
I mean, I talked about that woman who, because she was all over the news, who married she went off to marry the German guy who defected to ISIS, and then brought her two sisters with her, and they're still stuck in Syria. Jesus Christ.
I don't know who they are. This is the border?
Are they breaking into Syria? Yeah, take your son to a fucking war zone. That's a really smart idea. Good parenting skills.
That makes me sick.
It is boring too, so far. Like, nothing's blown up. Come on.
No.
Oh, they're just one big family. That's all ISIS is, guys. I mean.
Let me hear Aki. I can't believe we're here, bro.
It's for you. My friends.
This is Abu Anwar al Bastani that I told you about. His brother was Abu Hamid al Bastani.
Yeah, put that shit on real quick.
You better fucking do it.
Cut
your head off.
Oh, no, see, sisters. See, this is what the filmmakers want you to do. They do that little bit of, priming there, where it's like, oh, she thinks she's going to be in trouble for not wearing the headscarf. And
right,
look, it's, oh, welcome,
like,
sister.
No, okay.
No, that's, yes, this is not propaganda at all. That's, you know, not intentional, I'm sure. And in fact, you should feel bad. We should both feel bad for commenting on her putting on the hijab.
I know. If you're referring to people who are not your brothers and sisters as brothers and sisters, you might be in a cult.
You might! Just possibly! Oh, they said the stream shut down. Okay, wow. I guess. Okay. Who knows? YouTube's weird like that, though. Like, you've just randomly gotten shut down for no reason. So, who the fuck knows? I mean, I don't know. This is, so far, it has been just really goddamn boring, so,
It's been boring, but I feel sick. It makes me feel sick.
Oh, because it's absolute propaganda. Sick. It does. They are so unabashed. They're going to glorify it, and, yeah. We'll see how long we can go. Thanks, guys, for sticking through it.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
We'll see. Until we get labeled wrong thinkers and get
yeah,
this removed.
Yeah, get in trouble.
All right.
This way.
Also, the ISIS are very pious. Mm-hmm. They're not like, get the fuck over there. They're like, come here, brothers. Come here.
Yeah.
Here,
oh, yes. Of course they are. What are... Only a filthy fucking racist would think anything else.
Oh, are we just praying at the ISIS headquarters?
Yes, all they do.
Can we go to the room of sex slaves? Why don't we show that?
No. See, again, that's racist. Don't you know, they're all just very, yes, pious and peaceful, and they pray all day, and they do nothing else except for defend themselves. I guarantee that's going to be it. That's going to be what you're going to see the entire time.
Yo, where you going? I thought this was home.
Eh? No, Aki. This house is for the new arrivals, yeah? And the men who can't find women who marry them. I've got my own house, bro.
Bruv.
Don't worry, look. Blood. This is the Emir of the house. And make sure you don't do anything stupid.
So he's speaking...
I'll catch you 2 weeks later.
Yes, very, like, typical, colloquial British English, you know?
Sir, you pay no rent.
It said it's shut down again. I had a massive, massive YouTube tab open, that had, I'm gonna say 30 tabs of research in it. I think maybe that might have been fucking me up. Sorry.
Yeah. Okay. Go ahead. All right. Let's go back. All right. You're good. Okay. Yeah. Excellent. Here we go.
Plus an allowance.
My bad, guys.
From the store? Just let
First
us know.
Of all,
get it brought
they've
in.
Listed wonderful living okay. conditions, free you rent, go. Utilities, mm-hmm. food, and a white woman.
Anything you need.
Well, of course you get your white woman. No shit.
Just don't go outside. We lead back to the guns.
It really was research, guys.
To the guys.
Actually, while we're...
It really was not
porn. How do you break that down when you compare
Here's
to free rent?
Whatever you've heard,
well, that's what Linda Sarsour's entire argument is, right? It's like, oh, you'll never have any debt. Yes, you are legally owned by your husband, and you can't divorce him no matter how much he beats you, but, you don't have any debt.
Married as soon as possible, and we can help you with that. Now this... is where we meet.
I use Chrome because I'm lazy,
and
guys.
And hang out together.
Oh, we just hang out. We're just, oh, we at ISIS, we're just hanging out. It's fucking cheese and wine reception.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. This is egregious.
Excuse me.
This is egregious.
Okay, good question. Why aren't we all covered? Well, that's because the men never come here. Oh, I'm so sorry. That's incredibly rude, isn't it? Is men over a certain age never come here. So we can relax and be ourselves.
So what is it about men that requires you to cover
job,
yourself?
Which is to collect.
Can you explain that?
The men's fault. Oh my god.
I need to call home. I was told I couldn't do that when I arrived. They're gonna be worried.
Wait, I know, sweetie. But the phones have these built-in trackers and things, so we can't take the chance. The brothers will take a look at them. You can call home when it's safe. Once you're settled in. Okay?
Oh, yeah, there's,
Oh my god.
Jeez. Well, yeah, I mean, but they're so nice and lovely. And by the way, it's not their fault. It's these evil people.
Yeah, that was fine if we got stopped.
The evil people on the outside that are trying to prevent this woman from calling her family, because they're going to trace them.
Yeah, another lady, Bijani Balbach.
Aki?
It's my mother.
Did it crash again?
We don't have pictures of uncovered women here. Maybe you should delete it.
Doing anything. I don't know if making the playback video smaller is really going to help. Well,
I mean, I guess it's worth a try.
Okay, sorry, it's gonna be all tiny and stupid. And then you might see, like, this picture of a cute black girl that I put on my Google Drive, but...
There's nothing wrong with that.
Okay, we'll try it tiny, guys. Oh, that also will make it less likely for us to get content struck, I'm sure, for it to be all tiny. Not like anyone really cares about watching this horrible piece of propaganda, making sure we get all of its visual splendor.
Yeah. He got in trouble for a picture of mom. That's fucked up. He's now going to get a good talking to by the elders.
Tell him what are we?
Shui.
What's your name?
My real name or my cunha?
We don't use real names around here.
Abu Anwar Albertoni.
You're the brother of Abu Hamid, rahmatullahi Ali.
No. Did you know him?
Were you born Muslim?
Alhamdulillah.
What are your skills?
It's just like any typical job interview, really.
It's just like a job interview.
It's just, here you go, terrorism job interview.
You know the whole Quran by heart?
Yeah.
Al-Qara'a.
Mal-Qari'a. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْقَارِعَةِ يَوْمَ يَكُونُ
Don't they just put the new people right in front of the front lines of fodder? I'm pretty sure that.
Probably. But that's, no, look, you can't say that kind of shit.
Understand. So that we can decide.
This is what it's really like. This is why this documentary is so important. To get what it's really like. You get a nice little job interview. You get everything free and paid for. We can all hang out. Free wife.
That's very feminist.
And to spread the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala across the living lands.
Why are we watching this? Because this is propaganda that was aired on at least...
In the UK.
In the UK. Now, I should have made clear, I misspoke a little bit, that BBC4 is paid for by ads, not for by the British government. But you do have to pay the British government to buy a TV license to watch it. So in some manner, you are sort of paying for this through your, you know, shit with your taxes.
And you have ISIS propaganda being shown in a country that you're supposed to be at war with ISIS. That to me says you could be a defeated country. There's other aspects to that, but I think they are pretty much a defeated country.
By the way, thank you, GunFox61. I beat Muslims with the butt of my AR-15. Well, I'm a pacifist. I can't recommend that, but we are at war with them. So
If they're Muslim terrorists, I have an issue with that. But terrorists, I'm on board.
Yeah, terrorists, I agree. I'm on board with that.
What is with this? This is like a soap opera.
Well, of course. We have to show the human side behind ISIS.
No, ma'am. Can I have you cooking on your first night in Sham?
Big mommy white ISIS.
Okay.
Hazard are, I just said that. It has nothing to do with the BBC. It's a private company. But you do pay a TV license to watch it.
But, I mean, it should be illegal to put this on television. This is fucking propaganda for a group that you are at war with.
Yeah.
This is insanity.
But look, see how sweet and nice they are? We just can't have you working on your first night.
I don't know.
How old is he?
You gotta save your strength for the gang rapes.
Does father give his permission for you to travel?
Jesus Christ.
His father isn't around much.
Hey, that shit's true, man. That shit's true.
Once you make your bayah,
that you need a lot of energy for a gang
ISIS,
rape?
Well, no, that's probably true. I don't have any experience with that. But like ISIS, they treat people horribly. This is so insane that they would promote
it.
Well, there's no other way they can. But this is how you always get it, with the priming and framing. The absolute changing of everything in order to paint them in a positive light.
I was told online I could practice. I'm here to help build the state.
Help build the state, okay.
See what happens.
There are lots of ways we can serve. Our main job is to support the Mujahideen.
My Hijra isn't for anyone's benefit. It's a test of patience and hardship to see if I'm worthy to enter Jannah.
Yep, this is all about faith and religion. There is no political motivation at all. It's just about faith.
Oh, aren't they happy?
Yep. I mean, absolutely. You have to look at the visual devices being used here. Yeah, they're all so happy. Everything is perfect.
Your friend, that's the kunya she chose.
She's not my friend. We're not on the border.
She's upstairs. She's crying. Why, sweetie? Because she wants to go home.
I actually don't believe they allow... They even separate the male boy children from the women. That's actually unusual.
Probably.
I do believe...
Dude, they strap fucking AR-15s to them and tell them to go to a training.
That's true. I mean, even in more moderate Muslim groups, separate male children. Women are supposed to be subjugate.
I'm not even worried about the moderates. They can do whatever the fuck they want. I have no issue with the moderates. I'm talking about ISIS. These motherfuckers. There's plenty of footage of like 7-year-olds with guns getting prepared.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, but they're not going to show that side. Gunfox 61.
That would be racist.
Yeah, it was. It would be totally racist. Gunfox 61, I was in the U.S. military, got paid to beat up people that want to kill Americans. Thank you, sir. Absolutely appreciate and respect your service. Thank you. And thank you for the super chat.
Thank you.
I left without telling my parents where I was going.
Absolutely. That's fantastic.
I need to ring them. They'll be worried to death.
They'll be even more worried when they know where you are. What's the point? It's farad on every Muslim to make hijra. It doesn't matter what they think.
And if you know your deen, you know it's also farad to keep up the ties of kinship. Have you told your parents where you are?
Do you hear gunshots? No.
Well then.
Yeah, I think they accidentally allowed there to be some... Now, here's the thing. I'm sure that the gunshots are... The weapons are being aimed at them. This peaceful, calm unit of people. Although, never mind.
It was like, we're not extremists. And
immediately.
AKs into the air. These are totally not extremists.
No. They are just fighting for the same rights as anyone else. Don't you understand? These are revolutionaries. This is 1776 commencing right here.
Oh my god. Oh my god. No, keep. Passport! Passport! Oh, that's reasonable.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, just burn the passports. Okay.
Actually, strategically, I want them to burn their passports.
Well, then they can't come back.
Oh, I'm cool with that, actually. Throw that bitch into the fucking
Except,
fire.
You know, they do it anyway. Like, all the shit that happened in the UK specifically with this, where then the people came back.
Yeah, so the economists like, we got 400 of them.
Do you think all of them had passports? No, I bet they just let them back in because, whatever.
Yeah.
Now, again, a sign that you're in a cult of being, like, destroying external identities. That's disturbing.
I would be proud of you.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure.
Mm-hmm. What's up with that dude?
I don't know.
He's like kind of vacationing, got a Hawaiian shirt on.
Well, he said he was there. Maybe he'd go clubbing. He'd, you know, get some. He had
shorts.
That was
like their cover story. I guess that's why he's wearing it.
No, I think... What, do you think that's what it was? Is that it was his cover story, or that he just really didn't understand?
Or maybe he didn't. That's possible. He didn't understand because, like, the propaganda that they tell people through the internet sometimes is that it's like a paradise where you can like party and shit.
Right. Right. Well, of course, it's all part of the fucking propaganda.
Okay.
Look at how many white people.
Okay. Where are they?
Raqqa.
You have a truck full of hostages immediately. As soon as you cross into this country, you are hostages.
This is the capital. Raqqa's the capital.
Oh,
yeah.
Stop it. Stop it.
They're just tourists, man. You know, when I think of tourism and vacationing, I obviously think of going to a war-torn country in the middle of a civil war.
Yo, if you don't have a, like, a master skill, like the one, there was a white jihadi that was, like, a master, like, he was a fucking, like, war animal. This dude was just, like, crazy. And so he was an asset.
Right.
You're not an asset. You become more valuable as a hostage. How are they not immediately being taken as hostages?
You racist. Shut up. You're not allowed to say things like that. Yeah, that fat guy, I mean, he's not really good for much, I'm sure. Except for a human shield, I mean, he's wide enough.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I guess that guy just displayed his, value. Yeah.
I mean, is there like a population of white boys in ISIS that I'm not aware of?
Chris Hansen said something that I found hilarious, which was, these shots are too accurate for sand people. Thank you, Chris Hansen. Why don't you take
a
seat?
The one guy is a white boy.
Yeah, that's true.
UK military? I don't understand. They did have that one dude.
They every once in a while do get ex-British,
and he was a badass, and they joined ISIS.
Yeah.
And then he died, rightfully. I'm glad he died. But
this is Salama.
So I think they'll make an exception if they can use you.
Sit down. Come through, sit down.
In this class, we're going to teach you how to survive a gang rape.
Time for your re-education, obviously. See, they're training them how to save people, it looks like.
Oh, yeah.
Because that's all they're really interested in. They're, you know, establishing their peaceful state and saving their brothers. Grayscale,
the bullet of the white devil.
The evil white man. Grayscale played Chechens and other Balkan Caucasus people have a high concentration of white Muslims. They do! And there's less violence in the Balkans and Caucasus regions. You don't... I think this is there's a cultural aspect to it as well.
Interesting.
Because, yeah, there's... Okay. That's completely correct.
What do you want to know? The door is closed. The men are outside. No secret microphone.
And also, this has changed very quickly over time.
This is your chance.
Iran in the 1960s was pretty much what we would consider to be westernized, as much so as a lot of those countries in the Balkan Caucasus region.
It's a good question.
Oh, but the first thing they're interested in is how do I get a husband? Is that what she said?
You are covered from head to foot in black cloth. How do you get a husband in Dawla? The answer is, we help you. Oh. Most of us are married, and our husbands have friends. And their friends have friends. And if that doesn't work, Dawla runs a marriage bureau. Yes? Brothers who want to marry,
I do want to make an aside about this really quick. Like, we've been really good, Hard Bastard, you and I, well, despite all of the fucking bullshit that's happened to the stream,
yes.
You and I can tend to go off on tangents on shit.
Yeah, we've been very good about
it. We have been good at just watching. Well, it's really boring, so it's easy. But one thing that's interesting is I see exactly who this is appealing to here and what this is attempting to do, is that there has been an uptick in women in their 30s, early 30s, who are expressing a lot of anxiety and desire, and this is happening across Western countries, that they can't find husbands. There's multiple reasons for this. Feminism is probably the main one, and particularly considering the fact that the entire marriage system is completely flawed. Do you see who this is appealing to? This is appealing to women in their late 20s by saying, you know what, you can't lock down a dude. Come join ISIS. We'll find you a husband.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. That's crazy.
Absolutely. That's crazy. That is exactly who this is appealing to.
And they're letting it happen. They are just, like, broadcasting it on Channel 4.
Yep.
We help them make the right choice. So don't worry, sisters. There is plenty to go around.
Yep, plenty to go around. You could find yourself a strong man to marry you.
Oh, is that a suicide vest?
It's a dogma belt.
Sahih. Two uses for this belt. Come here.
I'm astounded at the number of white people. I mean, I know it's filmed in the UK, so, like, your options are a little limited. Well, not that much anymore, but...
It's a dummy, right?
First use.
No, it's not a dummy. Why would we bother with a dummy?
First use.
For me?
Yes, you.
Blow yourself up.
Crucial Bunny, lady is thirsty for dick, join ISIS.
Finished? First use.
There are no traps, I don't think. No cutie traps.
As a military tactic, you send in martyrs ahead of ground troops to blow a hole in the wall or on a defensive position.
Yes. And they will be green birds in Jannah, inshallah. Second use.
So they actually are describing this as a suicide vest.
Yes.
This is you kill yourself.
So if you're surrounded and there's no way out, to take as many of them with you as you can.
Yes. To take as many of the Mortadine with you as you can. To damage the enemy. And save yourselves the pain of torture.
I'm astonished that they have any ability to be accurate. But the thing is, it's all being portrayed as very positive.
Too attached to the brother next to you. His greatest wish is to be shaheed. It may be granted today or tomorrow.
Which is true, and I've said this before.
More than a year. So don't worry about
it. I've said this before, that it says in the hadith that it is better to be martyred than anything else, that the person, they go to heaven, the only reason they would ever want to return to earth is to martyr themselves again.
Yes.
That is the greatest, best thing you can do.
Mm-hmm. Material things you think you need. Keep focused on your deen. And bidnillah, you will be next on the list for martyrdom.
Another question? Women fight with the Kurds. Why can't we fight?
Okay. What a good question!
I am going to be straight with you.
Oh, how are you going to answer this
one?
There
is absolutely nothing for sisters to do here to take part in the fighting. Don't believe what you see online. There is no women's martyrdom operation. No secret sisters battalion. They are brothers who don't get selected for operations and get upset and start crying because they want to go. For sisters, it's completely impossible now.
Well, they admitted it.
Get yourself a weapon and learn how to use it. Because if some kafir comes in the night to kill you, you don't want to be looking for some man to protect you.
Oh.
But in a time of the Rasul...
Whoa.
Hang on, I'm a little confused.
I just totally...
Whoa, yeah,
it totally escaped me that there is a blonde-haired white woman sitting there. Perhaps I have not found the footage or the...
I showed you that woman who moved to Raqqa, the city they're in.
Right, but that was like an exception, was it not? Or no, is there just an influx of white people joining ISIS that I was not aware of?
I made two videos about it recently. There's a trend. I don't want to say it's an epidemic, but it's a trend And shit like this is exactly why there's a trend. Shit like saying, hey, you can't find a husband, you know he's gonna marry you after 2 days? Right. Some ISIS dude. A Gunfox 61, if the Muslims want to die, just run into an M60 or M240B. They will be more than happy to send you to your holy, unholy god. I mean, it's just part of the thing about jihad, is that it is on a little bit of levels in terms of, like, when you become, or you make martyrdom. Part of it is, like, how many people do you take with you? They even said that. How many people do you take with you? Which is why they're using the trucks, because the trucks have the greatest potential to inflict the most damage. And, you know, the more people that you take with you, the more beloved you are in the eyes of Allah.
Mm.
But yeah, I want to go back, like, a second, too. I hope this won't fuck anything up. Because I understand they're talking about how there are Kurdish women who are fighting, right?
And they're badass. I love
them. And they are fucking badass. And it's like, why can't we do that? So I want to just go back a second.
There is no women's martyrdom operation. No secret sisters battalion. They are brothers who don't get selected for operations and get upset and start crying because they want to go. For sisters. It's completely impossible now.
They say now, like it used to be okay.
Get yourself a weapon and learn how to use it. Because if some kafir comes in the night to kill you, you don't want to be looking for some man to protect you.
But in the time of the Rasul, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there were women who fought. Umamara.
In times of extreme danger for the Ummah. Women were called on to
okay.
fight.
Okay, this is called inoculation theory.
We're not in that situation.
Cersei, what can you do that man can't do better? Allah fashioned men
Ooh.
To endure jihad with strength and women to bear children. And Allah loves...
One sec. This is called inoculation theory. This mm-hmm. is a very, very basic tactic of persuasive speech. What happened right there is that woman, the blonde, presented an accurate but a weak form of the argument and was immediately rebutted. This mm-hmm. works exactly the same way as an immunization does, in that you give someone a weak form of the argument and then you can just rebut it, and then it becomes salient that that weak argument, that's actually a very good argument, why can't women fight? I even provided examples in Islam as to why women should and can fight, and then I immediately rebut. This makes the argument lose all of its sting. This is mm-hmm. intentional to destroy the argument.
Those who take care of their duty. There's lots we can do in jihad. We can't.
Excuse me. I understand we can't fight. But looking after the wounded mujahideen was a role assigned to the Sahabiyat in the times of the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
This is the same thing. They're going to keep going on.
So,
but...
mm-hmm.
we should be allowed to help the sick and wounded, shouldn't we?
Zubair was a doctor in Darul Kuf.
Why not? Dawla is calling on Muslims with all skills to come and build our new state. As long as you have your mahram and you remain covered.
So you as a successful doctor, yeah, you can do some shit. And we're pretending like this is fine and equal as long as you're there with your male guardian. This is fine and equal. This is great. Oh my god.
You some kind of soldier.
It's more than that, though. The honey badgers have talked about this a lot, particularly Karen Strong, which is that all of this shit, we often focus on how the women are disadvantaged in Islam. And it talks nothing about how men are viewed as less than human, essentially, as the most expendable. And this is like, we just saw the scene with the suicide vest. Men are so, they mean nothing in Islam. What is worse to the identity of a man than to be told that that's you right. are the most expendable that's thing in society?
Uh-huh.
Which is fucked.
He's the reason I'm here.
They're not, not liking the white guy, apparently.
Yeah, it seems like...
The guy just said, you don't look like any Muslim I've ever seen.
Huh.
What happened to him anyway?
Yo. Allow it, yeah?
I mean, he does look like Legolas, but...
He was martyred.
Well, the other dude. There's, I guess there's two now. That's
well,
Gabani.
Yeah. Commercial break.
Oh my god.
Yeah, this is awful. At least we've been able to get through. I think because mostly it's so boring. It's only
it is boring.
You know, 14 minutes left, and most of it, some of it'll be credits, I'm sure. But I've heard the next episode is awful. Now, if I can get this shit working, we can do multiple episodes.
Yeah, sure.
It's so not to start with the left when I'm dressing.
Yo, this Converse on it more than us, bruv.
Bismillah.
They're even so now they're making fun of him for being too pious and
no, I don't understand.
And they're just oh, and we're just gonna have some fun and play around in the pool.
Oh yeah, this is totally normal. They're just like everyone else, just ISIS.
Well, not only are they just like everyone else, but yeah, it's a vacation, isn't it? It is a vacation.
They're probably gonna fuck each other at some point.
No, that's very Haram.
No, that goes on. There was a huge fucking problem in Bethel with the Watchtower and Jehovah's Witnesses. There was tons of gay sex happening. They wanted to deny it. They disfellowship. There would be mass disfellowshipping because they don't accept that there's gay people in society at the Watchtower, and so you have to hide it.
Well, that's fairly common, yeah.
Well, Catholic Church has... I mean,
oh, absolutely.
Yeah, because the instructor thinks you're Paki Rambo, brother. Still, watch me murk you when there's brains involved in it.
Yeah. You reckon, fam? Yeah, you're going to murk me,
bro. You reckon, fam, bro.
Oh my god.
Well, this is getting a little bit homoerotic now.
This is totally homoerotic.
So if you're a little gay boy and you're looking to have some fun with your friends in a pool, join up with ISIS.
ISIS. Just don't get caught or you get thrown off the building.
Yeah. So for women, if you're over the age of like 30 and you're looking for a husband, join ISIS. Christ. If you're a little gay boy and you want to fuck around in the pool with some of your brothers, go ahead.
Just make sure you internalize it and don't tell anyone.
Yep.
Off the building you will go.
Yep.
Those dudes are idiots, though, for real. Like, how do you know that big-ass fucking bearded motherfucker ain't gonna come here, come out to the pool and be like, oh, all of y'all are going off the building. This is bullshit.
Well, because he's their brother. They all love each other.
What the fuck is going on here?
Oh, this is an Asian-style
Jesus
toilet.
Christ, what is going on here?
This is an Asian-style toilet.
In front of people.
Oh, wait.
Is she shitting or pissing?
I don't know. Maybe the audio's fucked up.
I mean, I don't...
Maybe she was kissing. I don't know. I thought she was shitting.
What, never?
No. It did kind of sound like shitty. No one is at least she knows how to pee in loo.
Fucking around. Oh my god.
Why are you here?
It adds to the incredible realism of this documentary.
Look at the chat. We're all saying the same thing. Like, what the fuck is going on here? That was a very graphic scene.
Sisters may follow you.
Holy shit.
Sisters may admire you. Praise you on Facebook. But ignore the
And very designated.
It's hard, of course. Women are the adornment of this world. The man is constantly tempted to seek her attention. But a woman in this life is defective. She carries urine and stool inside her whenever she goes.
Oh my god. This goes against everything I ever learned. I thought women didn't go
women
number two.
Women are defective because they have urine and stool inside them everywhere they go? Is that what he just said?
Yup. Women on this earth. No, hang on. Didn't you learn as a little kid that women don't poop? Obviously, we are so pure.
What?
but here's the whole point. Women
he's
on this.
Them,
yes, here's the whole. Yes, he's red pilling them. women on this earth are very impure because they're full of shit and piss. But when you get your virgins, they will be completely pure. There is nothing down the line. It's just it's just an empty abdomen. Just nothing.
Oh, so they just shit out like curry chicken and piss out.
They don't do anything. It's just tea. Fart perfume and piss tea. Yeah, probably.
Oh my God!
Jesus Christ!
How do you write that? As someone wrote that as dialogue.
I know.
She has many deficiencies, so ignore these temporary delights.
Ah, he knows this guy had condoms, so he knows he's a sinner. They've been there for what, like 3 days?
Yeah.
Again. Remember that you, as a mujahid, are known to 72.
This is,
women.
You know, this is like Full Metal Jacket, but if it was pro-military propaganda.
Yeah.
Watching you, staring at you every minute of every day.
Jihadi Luke Skywalker, yes. Using the Force.
The Hoor Al-Ain, a girl with the perfect eyes. The perfect figure and the perfect manners. A girl who knows no man but you. Who follows no one but you. And who likes no one but you. Remember, Shaitan works his hardest when you're on this blessed path. Again!
Oh, so now we get our nice recruitment video. How are they gonna spin this?
That's a good question.
You don't like it? That's okay.
It's okay, yeah. That's it's okay if you don't like the fucking beheading videos.
So why do we behead the kuffar? All it does is fill the enemy with fury. Make America more likely to send its armies here to fight us. It's stupid, no? No. It's not stupid. We want them to send their armies. We want them to defeat us.
What?
When will the last day come?
How is this legal?
I'm
the most fucking free speech ass motherfucker out there. How the fuck can you be showing something? If this was the Irish terrorism from the 70s, that shit's over. That conflict is over. This is a country, this is an organization that you are at war with, and you are allowing their propaganda over your airways. This is fucking disgusting.
I mean, I said this before, and it's something I'll say again, at least in a different manner, when you first talked about this, which is that this is like if some BBC channel, I don't care if they're not the ones that actually paid for the government, you still pay your fucking TV license to watch this crap. This would be like if this same channel had existed in 1940 and was fucking playing Triumph of the Will.
Yeah.
I mean, that is exactly what this is.
Yep.
Yeah, that means you're defeated, I guess. I don't know what else.
I think the UK is defeated. I do.
This is very sad. What did he just say, though, in the previous scene? That guy basically intimated that it's like, we want them to defeat us so we can get our virgins? Is that, or that we, so that we can go to heaven?
Basically. And I just want to, like, because someone in the chat just asked, what the fuck is this? Because people are coming in. This is ISIS propaganda that has been running on Channel 4 in the UK. It is a show that is basically sympathetic to ISIS. It's a docudrama, and it is being played in the UK. And yeah. I don't even think all four parts have even been broadcast yet. This is
Yeah, I don't know. But we, if you guys enjoyed this, now that we've got our shit set up a little bit better, if we do it again, you might actually be here. So it would be a little bit less.
I'll be down there. this is absolutely, I think it's unprecedented in regards to never have I been aware of a country that's at war with a group allow their propaganda over the airways to propagandize their citizenry.
Yeah.
It's incredible. It's absolutely incredible.
Is knowledge of the Our Sisters. But we know it will come when piety has given way to pride and truth to lies. When children are born out of wedlock. When usury, adultery, homosexuality, and the obedience of men to their wives prevail. When sex is performed in public places, and there is no imam to lead the faithful in prayer.
When people did you see she conflated some of that shit? Like, the grammatical sentence structure was off. It was like, she said a bunch of bad things, including usury, which they absolutely conflate with Jews 100%. No, I'm serious.
No,
the term usury
is
always conflated with the Jew, and they hate Jews more than the alt-right, or not that most people in the alt-right even hate the Jews. They hate Jews. Actually, you know, Hitler was quite fond of some Muslim countries, because he appreciated their hatred of the Jews.
Yes,
anyway,
very anti-Jew, yes.
But it's like she said, like, all these negative things, and then said, and commitment to the husband. I'm actually surprised they're going to get away with this, because it was things like children born out of wedlock, which the West has totally been for, which we've seen a massive increase in. So I'm not... I just want to see where this goes. I'm confused.
Eat with one another to construct high buildings. When earthquakes increase. Does any of this sound familiar?
What?
It's happening now.
So she's saying it's the end times.
The hour is approaching.
Oh, okay.
And at that hour, the army of the Mujahideen
faced
the Crusaders in Dabiq, here in Sham. And there, the Hadith tells us that our army will be defeated. Many, many brothers will die. Those that are left will take refuge in Jerusalem. And there, but only when we are in our darkest hour, when we are very nearly defeated, Jesus will come. Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam, he will descend at the white minaret in Damascus, clad in two yellow sheets, leaning on the shoulders of two angels.
Oh, they're trying to fucking pretend like Muslims believe in Jesus. He's a prophet, but he's not the prophet.
No.
Muhammad is the final prophet.
Every event has been foreseen by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is why we take the heads to provoke the West. That is why we have captured Dabiq. To wait for their armies there. Please, bring your bombs and tanks. Let them come. Our path to Jannah has been laid down by Almighty Allah, and we are following it step by step. Some of us
this beard crooked.
Will not live to see it.
It looks like a fake.
That's some fake-ass shit.
I mean, it looks like the strap-ons, you know?
In Jannah, inshallah ta'ala.
Looks like a beard from a Shaw Brothers movie.
Mm-hmm. Right, this is also a total misrepresentation of how Muslims view Jesus, but that's, you know,
so
everything about this is a misrepresentation.
Wait, you're telling me that there isn't a part where Muhammad then rolls up after Jesus? Why did they leave that out?
Because, well, why do you think? This is trying to appeal to the common person, to show you how human these people are. They're just
like
you
like
and me.
It's a recruiting video.
It's an recruitment video. It's like, well, maybe everything's not perfect, but if you came and helped us out, maybe it would be. How about that?
Yes. Do you remember your brother took every step you're taking, yeah?
Yeah.
So were you there when he died?
No. We're in different units, but I was there when he trained, Alec. He was good.
Yeah.
But Abu Issa tells me you're good too.
I'm you're pretty
class,
good.
Bruv.
Sorry, that's a Metal Gear reference. And the fucking, the swelling music. Oh, you get your, you get an AK, you get an AK, you get an AK. This is airing on National Geographic too?
No. In America? Not in America.
Oh God.
This is not airing in America.
Oh, we're all frenzies. Yeah, you were right in the beginning. If you call some, if you start calling everybody who's not your brother or sister, brother and yeah, sister, that's a little creepy.
Oh.
This is disgusting. I cannot believe
that you have to look at the framing of all this footage, the music, the emotion that's supposed to be being invoked, that these people are engaging or invoke or going off in this great quest that's like, oh, so brave. Oh, it's so beautiful. Oh, actually, I would like the gay orgy to begin. That would be nice. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Look at us, bruv. Started from the bottom, now we're here.
Wait.
Yes. Pause, that was a reference.
No. He did not just say we started from the bottom and now we're here.
Yes, he did.
Oh my God. What are you supposed to? Oh
what?
My God.
Because the rap music is totally cool in Islam.
Oh my God.
Don't you know how much they love the rap music? Culture?
And there's no outrage in the UK over this? There's no. I
don't think on a large scale. No one in the chat had really even heard of this. Like, it flew under the radar somehow, I think. Basically, everyone's just asking, like, what the fuck is this? You know? That's what I've pretty much seen. I don't know, like, what BBC4, like, how popular it is or anything. But fuck.
Okay, this says. Yeah. On Variety, an exclusive look at National Geographic's upcoming two-part miniseries drama, The State.
So they are going to air it on Nat Geo.
The State will air... Oh, my God. Okay. It will air on September 18th and 19th on National Geographic. This, we must immediately form a petition to stop this. This is outrageous. Unless they mean National Geographic in the UK and not here.
I don't know.
They cannot possibly do this in America.
This is unbelievable. Crazy Ace King, why did they greenlight this? Why is this allowed? Well, that's what we're wondering, isn't it? Well, I mean, I think we know why it's allowed and why it was greenlit. It's because it's, you know, self-hating. We have to apologize for being white. We have to apologize for being British and from the United Kingdom, because it's just so terrible. I think we got like a minute left, and then we can have like a short discussion. And then you will be doing your news stream afterwards, of course. Everybody. So let's finish this up. Sure. Oh, real quick, I do want to point this out, though, because I did get a response to that. Hazarar says, in the UK, nobody knows about it. Seems to have just aired with little promotion. Imagine my shock. They didn't promote this.
Oh, I mean, oh my God. Oh my God.
Okay.
The glorification of putting on the niqab. Jesus Christ. It's done in this fucking cinematic style.
America cannot air this. I'm gonna make a petition. Like, if no one's gonna do it, I'm doing it. America cannot air this. Okay. You cannot air this in America. We're at war with these motherfuckers. Are you fucking serious? You cannot air this in America. This is fucking ridiculous. Or, you know what? Air it in America, let two reasonable people narrate and pause it when necessary to point out the bullshit. Don't allow people to get propagandized. I cannot believe this. Yeah, Rocket Sturgeon said it, and I think he was the one that said it, and I looked it up, and I saw an article in Variety, and it's airing on the 18th and 19th of September.
Yeah, Jesus Christ.
In two parts.
And here's the thing. Based on the Breitbart article that you read on it, and that I looked into, this is apparently not as bad. Like, the second episode is worse.
Yeah. Yeah.
Including at the end, there is a fourth wall breaking at the camera shot of the black woman, who's the ostensibly the main character, basically saying, like, yes, the state isn't perfect, but which is exactly what all this has been. It's like, well, every once in a while, they'll give a little bit of a reason why it's not so great here. But if you came and joined us, maybe we could make it perfect.
Wow.
Yeah. Jesus Christ.
How did Breitbart not make a big fucking deal about it not airing in America?
When I heard you describe it, I was like, how did we not cover this? Because it's the kind of thing, or you and Winston Smith in terms of the cult watching stuff. Because this is absolutely a piece of propaganda, I think, without question.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You know, so.
This is heavy propaganda.
A little bit terrifying, yeah, that this aired.
Yeah, it's sick. I feel sick. I rarely feel sick when I cover shit. I feel sick to my stomach.
That they were allowed to get away with this, and that they were not only get away with it, but that nobody's saying anything about it. Because I have not seen anyone else on YouTube talk about this shit either.
Yeah, I'm starting a petition.
Fuck, man. So if you guys, at least in the chat, should I invoke alternative hypothesis? Alt-hype, is that what you mean by that? I mean, fine. I think at some point I'm going to be streaming with Millennial Woes. I don't want to talk about the crowd stuff. But, if you guys enjoyed us doing this, I think we both, now that we've got it figured out, be willing, if you're willing.
Oh, we have to. It's going to air in America. We absolutely have to do this now.
Yeah, I guess we're going to have to watch the whole four-part series, or it's going to be aired as a two-parter in Nat Geo. This is horrifying, guys. This is unbelievable that this was aired and that nobody is apparently incensed.
And they're going to try to air it in America for the first time in the history. Now, I can say for sure in the first time in the history of this country where National Geographic plans to air propaganda for a organization that terrorist we are currently at war with, for terrorists.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And like it's no big thing. That's reprehensible, that's repugnant and repulsive. All the R words that describe my disgust. Anyway, sorry for ruining your day. Didn't make me feel good either.
But I'm outraged now. I'm fucking outraged.
Oh, that's good, though. That'll fire you up for the news. Because
I was like, you know, the UK is conquered. Fuck, they're just going to do... fuck this in America, though. No way, man. We're not
No, this is not going to be all right. Anyway, guys, I think that's going to be the end of the stream today. I'm so sorry for the big cuts. Normally, I would just put this up straight. What I'm going to do instead is I'm going to download it, cut it up, so it's just the parts that aren't completely fucked. So if you just joined us later, you'll be able to watch this pretty much intact, as much as it is. There might be some jumps still, because we didn't know sometimes when the stream went out. But hey, we figured out, and thank you, Crucial, for telling me to put it in small mode, because that helped fix
that,
it.
That did work, actually. So, yeah.
So, it was clearly my fucking, my internet. And finally, Uppity Kokujin. So, is the intention supposed to be a propaganda recruitment video, or is it trying to be an objective view of ISIS like Downfall did for Nazis? Based on what we just watched, now, the director has said that it gets more complicated, so I don't know. But based on what the director has said, he says it's supposed to give you, like, a real look into it that's going to be objective. That seemed like pure propaganda to me.
Unless you... Because they've already painted some of the actors as sympathizing. Like the little boy, the guy that acts like a little boy with his little puppy dog eyes every yes. time he sees a beheading. If they have him suffer a brutal, savage death, and the point of it is to paint, this whole point is to paint ISIS as the savages they are, then I will retract everything.
I will as well. Absolutely.
But I don't expect that to happen. If they show yeah. women being raped, if they show the Yazidi women that they keep as sex slaves.
Yes.
Now, already we've had two parts, right? In the second part, they don't, the second part is even worse.
I don't know if the third part's come out yet, but I will tell you, someone asked where you can watch it. I would suggest to steal it, because I don't think you should pay for this shit.
Do not pay for this.
But it's going to be on Nat Geo, apparently, starting on the 18th. I found this online on Pirate Bay. Haha, I don't give a fuck. Yeah. So, but yeah, find it online if you really want to watch it. Otherwise, the two of us, I guess we're going to cover this. So.
Yeah, no question.
And then Crazy Ace King, real look when they never really seen it. Yeah, they have no idea. It's made by a white guy, I think, the director. Yeah, this is insanity. Anyway, thank you guys so much. I'm going to let Hard Bastard go because he has to prepare for his
own stream. 15, 20 minutes, I'll be doing the new stream. And thank you, everybody. Thank you, of course, Aiden Paladin. It was a pleasure.
Yeah, of course, as always.
See ya.
See ya. Bye, guys.